What is up, guys, and welcome to another vlog. So I'm about to go and do a workout with actually one of our clients. And this is something that we probably have manifested as well, because we've always said that one of our dreams is we wanna actually work out with you guys. So I'm gonna take you guys along, and I'm not gonna do like obviously the whole workout because I really wanna meet Tori. And I want to like spend some time with her, but I'll show you guys a bit of our workout, and I'll also introduce you guys to Tori. But yeah, let's get straight into today's video. So me and Tori are all warmed up. We just jumped on the treadmill for like 10 minutes, been catching up. Seriously feels like I've known you forever. Like, it's so crazy, the power of social media. It's so good.
I love it, love it.
So we're gonna jump into back and biceps, and we're just gonna jump onto the assisted chin-up machine. I'm just gonna do a couple of warm-ups here. Why do I feel like I'm running? Always chasing after something. Why do I feel like I'm running? Searching all the world for one thing. Wondering, wondering. Giving all I've got for one thing. Wondering, wondering. Searching all the world for one thing. Why do I feel like I'm running? Always chasing after something. Why do I feel like? Oh, that was such a good session. Oh, Tori is so lovely. Tori, if you're watching this, you're an absolute legend. Like, seriously, we just chatted the whole time. Feels like we've been friends for ages, and you guys know that's the power of social media. You can have this connection with people based on just what you know off social media, but feels like I've known Tori forever. Like, we have so much in common. She's so down to earth, so easy to get along with. Hopefully we'll definitely be catching up with Tori again, and going home now to eat. I don't know if I told you where JD is. My head is like freaking scattered at the moment. But JD is actually filming at the WBFF. I'm so jealous. He's actually filming for Robbie Frame, who is an absolute legend. So yeah, he's been filming for him all yesterday, all this morning. And yeah, he's there till like late tonight. So we will probably pick up this vlog tomorrow, because I'm going home to relax, unwind. I'm gonna go pamper myself, put on a mask, and I'm also gonna go watch RuPaul. So I'll see you guys in the next clip. All I can say is thank God for makeup, because it is covering exactly how I'm feeling right now. Dog tired. But I'm about to go to the gym and hit another session, and then I'm going to do a bit of posing practice as well, because every Sunday I usually do posing practice. I'm trying to do it at least 4 to 5 times a week. I must admit, I have been slack, and I do need to pick it up, guys, because today marks 2 weeks out till show day. But all day, we have not vlogged, because this has literally been JD all day. He's been editing this video, and then he's got another video that they want done in a week, and this one needs to be done in 2 weeks. So they're both really like important videos that he needs to get done ASAP. So we just need to get knuckled down while we've got the time off, and just suck up that we're using all our weekend and public holiday. So yeah, I'm gonna leave JD alone, because sometimes I annoy him and distract him. So I'm gonna go and hit a session, and I'm not gonna film it for you guys because I just wanna get in the zone, and then I'm gonna show you guys where I'm at 2 weeks out with my physique. Feeling a little bit watery today. I've had a lot of water, but yeah, feeling pretty good. Yeah, I'll show you guys my posing. Not gonna lie, guys, that session was really hard. I literally just did triceps because my energy was just so low tonight. So I thought, I'm just gonna go light, just do triceps, just get a really good squeeze. And then I jumped on the bike and it felt like I've never done cardio in my whole entire life. My energy is super low today. I'm super drained. And I was like, should I go and pose? Like, I'm in a pretty negative mind space. Like, I don't feel very well. Feel a bit sick today as well. But I just started posing, and oh my God, I'm so pleased with where I'm at. I'm incredibly happy with where I'm at. I felt really water retention today, but like just posing in front of the mirror then, I can see all my striations, my muscles are popping, my definition is coming out as well. So I'm really glad that I actually come in here and pose, because it's actually put my mind at ease, and I definitely feel like I'm on track. I feel like my body fat percentage has definitely gone down, and now all I'm concentrating on is just doing exactly what I'm doing. Keep doing the carb, low carb days, carb up days, keep my fasted cardio in how it is. And all I need to do, guys, is just keep dropping my body fat percentage and dry out for the day, and I'm sorted. All right, I'm gonna show you guys a bit of posing. I'm just figuring out where to put it. It's the best place to put it. All right, I'm gonna put you guys over here. I'm literally like facing it into the gym, so I have to face everyone that's in the gym. But you know, all right. Me and JD did a really good session this morning, but I need to grub off this tan because we've got 2 weeks to go, guys. And I need to start prepping my skin so that the comp tan will go on really nicely. And also, I've got like a couple of acne scars on my back that I want to make sure that the tan doesn't stick to, because if you have any scars in that, the tan really sticks like really badly to it. So we got sent these body scrubs by Butt Naked. They are 100% vegan, tested only on humans, not animals of course. We have tried this one before and it smells really good. This one I'd highly recommend if you guys have a bath, because it's got things like lavender. It's very relaxing as well. But today I'm gonna try out this coffee scrub because it's also got Epsom salts in it as well, and mint, and it's really good for workout recovery. But we also managed to get a discount code for you guys, so if you buy two or more items, you will get 20% off your entire order. So I'll leave the discount code on the screen for you guys. I'm gonna go jump in the shower and get butt naked. From getting a few things from the shop. Every time I pick up the camera, it's like a different day. Come home from the gym, pretty much that is my life. But I just did like a little bit of a haul. I went to Aldi, Woolworths, and I also went to Flannery's as well. So I got JD some stuff, and I also got some stuff for myself. So a little bit of a haul here. I got these for JD because he's been having either Maple Crunch, or he has the Exos, which is kind of like a Cocoa Pops chocolatey cereal. He has these post-workout because they're like a big hit of carbs straight afterwards. Got in some more yogurt. And when I have my higher carb days, I have anywhere between 6 to 8 of these cookies, and I am so obsessed with these. I also got some of these sea salt and balsamic vinegar rice cakes. I'm gonna trial one of these before my workouts and just see how my body reacts with adding in some extra salt before a workout, because salt helps you get a bit of a pump if you have depleted it for a little while. I got JD's bread. Oh my God, so good. This bread, we've told you guys before, it's very low carb bread, but it's also 23 grams of protein for 2 slices of bread. But fun fact, guys, I ran out of this peanut butter yesterday, and because it was a public holiday, I couldn't get any more, so I had to use the Kraft one. But the Kraft peanut butter compared to this is insane with the macros and the calories. So calories for the Kraft one were a lot higher, and then also the sodium in this is like none. There's like no sodium in this whatsoever. And also the carbs were more than double for Kraft. So it just goes to show, guys, if you change little things here and there in your diet, it can make a massive difference to your macros and your calories. What is up, guys? This vlog is, I don't even know what's going on in this vlog. It has been all over the place. So we do apologize if it seems a little bit all over the place, but we've literally just been so flat out this week that we've just been picking up the camera where we can, updating you guys where we can, but far out, it's been a massive week.
There's some like massive, massive stuff that's gonna come out soon from us. In regards to JD's really productions, which is what we've been working on. So this is sort of taking a little bit of a back seat, because we had to grind and get it done, because it's going to be big,
definitely
big stuff.
And I've been training my freaking butt off. Mm. And like all day, I was so tired today. So I decided that today was gonna be my high carb day. So I've had a bit of carbs today and I'm feeling a lot better.
Rest day.
Yeah, and it is on my rest day, and you shouldn't really have your high carb day really on your rest day because you wanna use those carbs for your workouts. Mm. But because I was just so tired and drained, and update guys, I got my period yesterday. So I think that has something to do with it. But I'm going to do a big leg day tomorrow and I'm gonna use these carbs tonight to fuel my workout tomorrow. Mm. And yeah, just intuitively always listening to my body, and it felt like I needed carbs, so I gave it carbs. But exciting news, guys, because registration is open for the comp finally. Mm-hmm. And I'm just deciding, oh, I haven't even got the camera on me. I'm just deciding what ones I wanna go in. I'm obviously going in novice fitness, novice sports, but I'm just wondering if I should do sports model open as well, which is like overall of sports model. So it's a pretty hard category to go in, but that's kind of the money situation.
What about, why is Miss Fitness model novice so expensive?
No, that's like your first, whatever first one you choose is $175. This is how much it costs, guys. So it's $175 for your first category, and then it's $75 on top of that every single time you want to add a category.
Plus,
and then
pitches.
I'm also doing behind the stage pitches and on stage pitches as well, because last time we didn't get like any.
Yeah.
And like JD's obviously going to be filming on the day, but I want to get like stage shots, still shots, and I don't want to have to worry about JD doing that. And I kind of regret doing that last time, but that's an extra $95. So I'm up to $420, guys. When you take away, I've got to get two tans, I've got to get my makeup done, I've got to get my nails done, I'm getting my eyebrows done.
It ain't cheap.
And I will be wearing my suit that I wore last year, just to save costs, and I love that suit anyway, so.
So we're gonna sign up for this, but you know the drill. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And we promise that the next one will be a lot more interesting
structured
than this.
Yeah, next week is going to be peak week, guys. So peak week means we're gonna be doing a few things differently, but we'll let you guys know.
We'll document it all and show you in the next videos.
Yeah, so we'll see you guys in the next one. So my stomach has come in a lot this week, and I feel like I owe that to definitely the fasted cardio. So I have lost a lot of stubborn fat around my abs, because that's where I hold a lot of my fat. My arms are tightening up a lot, losing a bit more fat around like my chest area. And yeah, my chest is quite shredded as well. Losing all boobs altogether, like literally say bye to those.